should have any doubt in your mind about what you're supposed to do tonight and about how you're supposed to do it. Yeah, I would do the game another yard.
We gotta go out there and get a touch.
Take their game and shove it right back in your face.
That's how winning is done.
Just need to go on to you. Do you feel?
And I guarantee you, we'll find them like a whole different walking out, letting them get the best gates.
I'll ask you one last time.
To be the best you could be.
What are you like, Sam?
Win. It's my heart. It's about who you go out there and play the hardest.
It's about how hard you need to get hit and keep moving forward. I don't care what the scoreboard says at the end of the game. In my book, we're going to be winners.
He's a six-time pro.
manager, Brandon Delamere, team fire director, Dale McDonald, and from NFL's official physio provider, the most beautiful strength and conditioning coach, Fred Savoy, and trainer, Jonathan Cormier. A pledge will be said at every game as well as community event that the team attends this season. Join in and take a pledge at thepledgetoendbullying.ca. I invite everyone to stand with us today, and I invite Sean Van Zandt and Neil Paul Hollihan to come say the pledge with us.
I think that everybody has a right to live in a community where they feel safe, including valuing the subject, regardless of differences of a pledge. Respectful of others and stand up against bullying whenever and wherever I see you.
Je crois que tout le monde a le droit de vivre dans une communauté où chacun se sent sécurité, intégré, estimé et accepté indépendamment de cette différence. Je m'engage à être respectueux des autres et à agir contre toute intimidation là où je la rencontre. Let's go!
Here to perform O Canada, Erica Obey.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Moncton Coliseum.
Let's go.
It's playoff time.
Yeah.
I'm Tia. I got my brother Joey.
How you feeling today?
We're about to have a good time. The building is loaded up with people.
Yeah.
It's going to be a good night, a good day here.
Oh, it's going to be crazy. It's an exciting atmosphere here at the Coliseum. We have it packed out here. A lot of Halifax people made the drive up. It's going to be crazy here.
Yeah, man. And series is split now, 1-1. Went to Halifax and did what you're supposed to do in the playoffs. If you're the away team for the first couple of games, you got to get one.
They did
their job down there.
Yeah.
And they're back to hopefully get one here in the Coliseum.
Well, hopefully,
to get two, obviously.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
We'll see what happens. Building is electric right now.
Yes.
It's like there's two games happening today. You've got the game on the court, and then the game in the stands. Halifax and Moncton trying to see who can be louder.
Yeah. Miracles are definitely going to need to feed off this crowd. Come up with some excitement and, hopefully get a couple easy baskets right off the start.
And this atmosphere. This is a fun atmosphere right now. Like, I'm already fired up a little bit for this game. Big factor for Halifax, going to have to keep an eye on him, especially is Nick Young.
Oh, for sure.
Did I say Nick Young? Kevin Young.
Kevin Young, sorry, yeah. That was it.
Sorry, now that I know he ain't Swaggy P.
Yeah.
Kevin Young is a factor for Halifax to watch. And for the Miracles, we're going to keep our eye on Trayvon Lathan, who's definitely going to get hit.
Yeah.
And Stanley Robinson, who's in the starting lineup tonight. So
that's nice right there.
Trayvon Lathan with the ball, gets it over to Van Zandt. Van Zandt puts it on the floor and attacks. Great ball movement by Moncton to start. Brooks comes off short. Kevin Young going to bring it up himself, gets it ahead to McMorrow. He gets the first two for Halifax. Trayvon Lathan comes right back for two
and
of his own.
That's what they need from Trey, right? They need Trey to go to the basket, attack, and get to the free throw line. That's going to be big tonight, this afternoon.
Well, I think this game especially, and the game on Tuesday, it's going to come down to your stars being stars.
That's it, right?
Right? Like, you throw that unselfish stuff out the window, play your game, be a leader, and do your work. Tyler Murray gets the breakaway layup. Saya Ando uses the screen, gets it over to Young. Young lobs it into McMorrow, he gets two.
That looks like a set play for Halifax. You gotta watch McMorrow inside.
Right. Well, the thing is you gotta make him have to go through you, right? Yeah. Lathan to the hoop, gets another quick two.
Like we said, Lathan, you know, he can make his shot kinda anytime he wants, right? This other guy's got to step up here for the Miracles.
Young with the ball.
We got
turnover. Daquan Brooks comes out running. He's going to split the defense and attack. He's fouled. To the line he goes.
Way to attack by Daquan.
Woo, this is exciting out here today.
Yeah, yeah.
Caught myself on the play-by-play there. I was, man, I better catch my breath. I'm getting, I saw him go to split the defense. I just started, and Brooks about to split the D.
Well, we knew where he was going. He was going straight to the basket. You know, you need that. Get to the line.
Got us acting like Jack and Devil. First free throw off for Brooks. Second one's good. Little trap there on Ando. Over to Joey Haywood, back to Saya Ando.
That's good pressure by the Miracles.
McMorrow's fouled as he goes up. He gets it to fall.
McMorrow real deep down in that paint, like he's going to be hard to handle, right?
Oh, he's definitely going to be a problem if he gets in there, right?
So.
And I mean, that's one of those goes without saying. You know he's going to be a problem. He gets the ball in there, right?
That deep for sure.
Yeah. McMorrow to the line for one. Free throw's good. Free throws are going to be important for both teams.
Yes.
Especially as we see how the refs are going to call this game, because you know it's going to be an intense battle. Sean Van Zandt with the jumper comes off. McMorrow pulls it down. Here comes Saya Ando for Halifax.
Attacking is going to be big for the Miracles, right? You want to get to the line.
Joey Haywood misses. McMorrow with the rebound. He goes up strong for two.
That's a big dump by McMorrow there.
Well, I mean, he's a factor for Halifax, right? And like we said at the start, like, stars are going to have to be the stars. Murray with a great lookaway pass for Robinson. Robinson, he goes up. He's fouled.
And that's what you got to do, right? You get McMorrow, kind of get him in some foul trouble. Maybe he could sit down for a minute, right? That's a good, strong move by Stanley Robinson inside.
Absolutely. Gotta attack the mountain, right?
Like
when you have a big thing in front of you, figuring out how you're gonna approach it, climb it.
Yeah.
You got a big hill?
Yeah, that's it, right?
Go up the hill.
Put him in situations he doesn't want to be in, right? That's the big thing.
9-8 is the score. 9:20 remaining. Stanley Robinson on the free throw line. Misses the second, gets his own rebound. He's in too early. On the flip side, I don't mind the Stanley Robinson McMorrow matchup.
No.
I think Stanley can play.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, of course, McMorrow outweighs and is stronger than everybody in the league.
Yeah.
No problem.
But in situations, right? It's all about situations, right? Putting them in tough situations.
Murray with the look away. Gets tipped and out of bounds. Going to be miracle ball.
Right idea, though, but quick hands by the Rainmen to get a hand on that.
Do you think Murray should take that shot?
I'm not sure.
Van Zandt catches on the inbound. Dribbles out to get an offense. 10 on the shot clock. Into Trayvon Lathan. Lathan takes the turnaround. Comes off. McMorrow with a rebound. Almost traveled there.
Yeah.
And
looked like he drugged their pivot foot there.
Yeah. Back to Haywood. Haywood looking inside for Young. Van Zandt gets involved, comes away with the steal. Trayvon gets it up to Stanley Robinson. He's going to attack. He attacks, misses, but gets fouled.
Yeah. That's going to be a big key this game. We were talking free throws. That's a big key, right? The Miracles, they like to take a lot of jump shots, right? Well, I would say they're more like a jump shooting team, right? So them getting inside, right, putting the Rainmen in foul trouble and getting to the line for easy baskets, getting guys going, that'll be big.
Right. First free throw good for Stanley Robinson. Makes the second. Good to see the Moncton faithful putting up a fight, too. You're not going to be louder than us in our building is the attitude they're coming out with.
Yeah, the Rainmen fans are getting drowned out right now.
Andu just steps into an easy jump shot. Ooh, Tyler Murray. As the old saying, Tyler Murray just put Kale in the spin cycle.
Yeah.
Put him on skates.
Great finish, too.
I got all the cliches, bro. Put him on skates. Gave him a haircut.
Yeah.
Ando gets fouled going up.
Ando's always a threat for the Rainmen, too, right?
Yeah.
You got to watch him.
Oh, he's definitely dangerous.
You got to watch him.
13-12 is the score in favor of Halifax with 7:41 remaining in the first. Saya Ando to the line for the Rainmen. First one good. Makes both.
I mean, we have a definite foul on Young. Little bit of kerfuffle.
McMorrow in there pushing around.
Well, this is a playoff game, right? You know, you're not going to let no one push anybody around here, not in our house. I mean, I'm not sure what Trayvon was supposed to do there. Like, Nick Young jumped on his back.
Right.
What's he supposed to do? Kind of, you know, get off me. No.
Teams being sent to their benches as the refs figure out what they're going to call here. If it's my guess, you've got foul on Nick Young, and you've got a technical on McMorrow.
Hey, that's exactly what I was going to say. Took the words right out of my mouth.
They gave McMorrow the unsportsmanlike.
Yeah.
Same deal. And ladies and gentlemen, we have us a game. Trayvon misses the first of two. Moncton will get these.
Well, this is the playoffs, right? You know.
Moncton will get these two shots and the ball.
You want your team fired up on both ends. A little bit of intensity here. And anytime you're subbed, you get mad. Doesn't matter what happens, right? You get subbed, you get up mad. Like, oh. So you can't really fault Nick Young on that one, but
right.
You were overzealous.
I don't know what you're jumping there for anyway. Well, they like trying to take a shot from the end of the hoop.
Yes, exactly,
the end of the court.
Right? Like, what are you going for?
Van Zandt brings it across. Good ball movement. Tyler Murray takes the three, follows the shot. McMorrow comes up with it.
We have a
hustle for the ball. Great hustle. Chris Cale wide open.
You're the miracles. You can't sleep, though. And Trey definitely fouled there going to the basket.
Oh, well, this is the time, right?
Yeah.
Like, if you're
yeah.
Trayvon Lathan,
yeah.
attack, attack, yeah. attack.
Yeah.
Well,
like, if I'm Trayvon Lathan, I mean, you got to be very brave for this plan I'm about to come
yeah.
up with. But if I'm Trayvon Lathan, I'm coming to the hoop, I'm getting to the line, and I'm yeah. telling you about it.
Yeah.
You want to stay in McMorrow's head now,
yeah.
right? Because a player like that, although you're going to feel it, you make him over-aggressive.
Oh, for sure.
He'll
for
put
sure.
himself out of the game, right?
Yeah. Well, it's that mental game, right? That mental game.
That's it.
Right? Get in the guy's head.
Daly throws it away. McMorrow's going to the line for two. Ferguson coming in. Also a guy that I would trust in that situation with McMorrow. Strong
yes.
body, not afraid of anything
yeah.
or anybody. This will be good.
One of the biggest things for the Miracles as well right now is they're getting that first shot attempt up, right? And, but
right.
they just got to protect that, you know, the defensive board, right? Because
right.
that's what's kind of in the way. He's kind of keeping Hollow on the, you know, on the offense. McMorrow with most of those offensive rebounds.
Tyler Murray gets it over to Van Zandt. He's attacking. To Murray, Trayvon Lathan checks the line, takes the jumper, it's off. Ando comes down with it. Here comes Saya Ando for Halifax. Jermaine Daly called for the illegal screen.
Well, Daly stuck out that knee, right? I don't know if he meant to do it on purpose, but the knee was out there. And Daquan's real good at
right. and
making
yeah,
it
no,
look
I'd never,
like it, right?
I like, I love Jermaine Daly's game.
Yeah.
And, yeah, he's actually a good, solid guy.
Yeah.
But then the flip side is, too, once you're set there like that,
yeah.
Daquan Brooks is good at making you have to come out of your set to even play it.
Yes.
Van Zandt called for the travel. Halifax gets it back. 19-14 is your score with 6:12 remaining in the first.
Thank you.
Tough defense for Daquan Brooks. Chris Kale takes the long three, comes off. McMorrow misses the dunk. Daquan Brooks comes out, gets it up to Van Zandt, bounce pass. Trayvon gets it to Ferguson. Ferguson's fouled as he goes up.
I like what the Miracles did there with numbers, right?
That was a great job.
I actually thought that Trayvon was going to shoot there, and he kind of got it off,
well,
right?
Well, he forced him to make a decision, right?
Yeah.
Because on that pass, the only option left is you're either going to give Seamus Ferguson the layup or you're going to foul him.
Yeah.
Because Trayvon put him in a bad spot, right? Yeah. Put the defender in a bad spot. So we have our first timeout with 5:45 remaining here in the first quarter. 19-14 is the score in favor of Halifax over the Moncton Miracles. We'll be back shortly. We're back here at the Moncton Coliseum. 19-14 is the score with 5:45 remaining.
Big free throws hit by Seamus Ferguson there.
Ando with the ball, steps back, clink scales, looks inside to McMorrow. Stolen away from Brooks. Brooks is running, he attacks the hoop. He's going to the line.
Daquan has turned it up today. Well, he's turned it up almost every one of these games, actually, all these playoff games. Shooting very good.
And knowing how to use his body, right? Yeah. Like he's taking the hit and going up. And he's putting you in a position where you have to hit him.
And I think these free throws, too, as well, once you start seeing those shots start falling, right, then the three and the jumper start falling as well. So this is very good for Daquan.
Trayvon Lathan called for the foul underneath.
It's a good pass by Ando inside there, splitting the defense.
Ball comes in, Klingscales with the ball now. Another great point guard for Halifax. It's like they don't run out of great point guards in Halifax right now. Great move inside. Klingscales gets two.
Solid move by Klingscales there. Kind of the fake to the corner and then hit the nice runner.
Defense! Brooks for three. Comes off, rebounded by Watson. He's going to run, gets it up to Klingscales. Daly loses the handle. Here comes Van Zant for Moncton. Watson bringing it back for the Halifax Rainmen. 21-18 is the score with 4:03 remaining here in the first quarter. Klingscales looking for a screen from Daly. He's going to attack. Drops it off to Watson. Watson's called for the travel.
Definite travel there.
Matthews comes in to give Trayvon Lathan a break. Now this is where what I think that the talk about the rebounding and stuff will play in.
Yeah.
Is to see how Moncton adjusts now rebounding wise with McMorrow on the bench.
Yeah.
Matthews comes up shooting, three pointers off. Klingscales on the move. Big basket by Spikes. Van Zant attempts to blow by on Ando. Matthews gets another shot at
That's
it.
That's a good look. Matthews is going to have to come up big this game off the bench.
Well, and that's just it. He's just got to hit those open shots,
yeah,
right?
Well, that's it. They're open shots, right? He has to drop those.
Klingscales with the ball now. Throws it into Daly.
Matthews in a deep position there. That was a bad position for him. Daly backed him in real far under the basket. What can he do, right?
And I mean, even Matthews has to see that's a mismatch.
Yeah.
Like, if Daly catches the ball there, you're in a post.
Yeah. That's it.
He'll put you in the rim.
Yeah.
And by the look of it, Daly knew too.
Oh, yeah.
Spikes is fouled going up.
Ferguson getting out of position here, but he got back for the block. We'll see how Spikes does on the free throw line here. Got caught up in a screen there, but he still got back and got the block.
Yeah.
I like the effort.
.248 remaining here in the first quarter. 23-21, Halifax in front. First one good for Spikes. Ferguson goes up for the rebound. Brooks with the great crossover move. He attacks the hoop, gets two.
I was about to say, he has so much room at the free throw line, he could have popped the jumper right there, but.
He's playing Scottie Pippen style today.
It's either I'm gonna go to the line or I'm gonna make a shot.
He's a really big 5'9 tonight.
Yeah.
Gets his hand in there, Klingscales with the crossover move. Spins, goes up, knocks it down.
Klingscales more known for his defense, but I think he's offensively
Don't sleep on him.
Well, that's it, right? He kind of said, I'm going to step up my offensive game.
K.O. checks back in for Halifax. Yeah, I definitely consider Klingscales a two-way player. Like, he's good on both ends.
Oh, for sure.
It's over to Watson. He attacks. Gets the layup to fall.
Right now, if you're Moncton now, you want to close this quarter out on a high note. Get some good looks, some good shots.
Van Zant with an attack. He's going to the line. And I mean, you can easily see the difference in the way that Moncton's playing today.
Yeah.
Like they're not just taking jump shots.
Not settling. They're kicking out not, for jump not, shots. Not right? settling,
yeah,
too,
like
right?
They're attacking the hoop. They're kicking out for jump shots, not just jacking them up.
No.
Van Zant with the free throw.
I mean, when you looked even at that last play, I mean, you had two shooters at the three-point line, and Van Zant was, I'm going to go to the line, right? I'm going to get there. I'm going to make contact and, you know, get to the line or make a layup. Because Van Zant can make that layup, too, yep. right? So.
And you keep the attitude of, you know I have shooters. I'm going to attack the hoop. If I get stopped,
yeah.
I got shooters.
Exactly.
Right? You know what I mean? Especially when you have shooters like a Chris Matthews.
Yeah.
You know, don't force him to have to create his own shot.
Yeah.
If you create shots for him, he'll knock them down.
Yeah.
Checking in for Moncton number 50, Neil Fulahan.
Fulahan checks in for the Miracles. Coach Land just going through his entire lineup there for big men, using them all. Can't blame him. KO with the up fake, steps into a jumper, knocks it down.
That was a good close out by Matthews there. KO with a nice pump fake to get around him for an easy jumper.
Tyler Murray comes over, 10 on the shot clock, trap up high by Halifax. Matthews throws it away, and we have a foul.
Halifax on that possession, it turned up the defense right there.
Absolutely. Clint Scales got really excited about it, too.
Yeah, did he? But he gets fired up, though.
Yeah, I knew.
He gets fired up, right? He's kind of like the defensive leader, like the linebacker of the team.
Yeah.
Like, you know, Ray Lewis, I say.
I was just
more like
say,
a Ray Lewis, right?
That's Ray Lewis, man. Yeah. And, I mean, what it does, too, is he's that good of a defender that he holds you accountable.
Well, that's it, right?
Right? Like, when he starts yelling and screaming, you better defend, because he is.
Yeah.
Second free throw good, 31-25 with 48.5 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. Tyler Murray pushing it up. He attacks, he's fouled.
Looking for the goaltend call there, but it's looking like it's just a two-shot foul.
No goaltend call on that play. Tyler Murray to the line. First one's good. 40.3 seconds remaining, both teams in bonus. Fisher checks in for Halifax. Or Foster, sorry.
We have a foul.
Fulahan picks one up on the rebound.
I'm not sure if I like that call. Fulahan and Spikes battling together. Looked like a nice clean battle, but Spikes will go to the line to shoot two here.
Spikes makes the free throw.
knocks both of them down. 21 seconds remaining in the first quarter. 1 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock.
Bit of a miscommunication there by Murray and Follahan.
10.1 seconds remaining.
Defense.
Big shot comes off. Battle underneath for the rebound. At the end of the first quarter, the score is 33-27. Halifax Rainmen leading the Moncton Miracles here at the Moncton Coliseum. We'll be back with you shortly.
We're back here. Battle between the Halifax Rainmen and the Moncton Miracles. NBL Canada playoffs. Halifax are possessing the ball here. Clink Scales. Over the Foster. Halifax back with possessing the ball. Wudu Apaya. Back to Foster. Watson attacking. And he's going to go to the line to shoot one. Van Zandt picking up the foul.
Fouls on Moncton number 23, Sean Van Zandt. His first. Checking in for Moncton number 24, Stanley Robinson.
Watson to shoot one here. It's good.
Knocks it down. 36-27 is the score. We're just started here in the second quarter. Tyler Murray comes across half, picked up by Klingscales. He's going to attack him. Klingscales called for the foul.
Well, being an intense defender as Klingscales, you know you're going to pick up fouls.
Right.
You got fouls, you know you're going to be having three or four used because you're attacking, right? That's the game plan, right?
Mm-hmm.
Van Zandt picked up by Apia. He attacks, takes the runner, comes off. Van Zandt, though, is totally capable of playing through this physical type of game, right?
Oh, yeah. So. Yeah. Halifax has definitely turned this into an old school battle.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see how far I can take it, right? So right now, the Miracles are going to have to turn up that physical game because coming out in this second quarter, we've seen what they've been doing so far.
Watson gets the ball in the inbound, moves it to Clink Scales. Lobs it out. Big shot. Missed by Foster. Matthews with the ball gets it over to Van Zandt, who's going to bring it back for the Miracles.
And that's a big defensive rebound by the Miracles right now. Need to protect that.
Matthews takes the fake, steps over, knocks down the three.
He needs to be big, right? He needs to be big this game, right? Chris Matthews, that is. He needs to be big, right? And those are the shots he gotta hit.
Clink Scales lobs it in.
Spikes fouled again under the basket.
Back to the free throw line.
Yeah.
Kale checks back in. Kale having a very quiet but effective game so far tonight. Misses the first of two.
That's his first one, his first miss. Spikes hitting his free throw shots.
Second one good. Murray gets it over to Chris Matthews. He comes up shooting.
Dwayne Smith paying dividends. Big rebound.
I was interested to see how Smith was going to come out tonight. Today, just he's such a solid guy in there, right? Shot comes off. Murray pulls it down. He's looking to run.
Well, he does a lot of good things well, right? Can shoot the three, can attack the basket, can pass, right?
Good timing. Very good timing, Joey.
But then
Rainmen is on the run. Foster for three. Stanley Robinson puts it back for Moncton.
I think that was a pass. They should give him an assist for that one. No, I'm sure they should. They should give him an assist for that one.
Clink Scales for three. Murray splits the defense and attacks. He's fouled. Gets the layup to fall.
Wow. Beautiful move by Murray there, going to the basket.
He scored on three people.
Did he?
He crossed over one, split him and his friend, gets to the hoop, gets another.
And then the old English at the end, the kind of the backward spin, roll inside.
That's that. I got a new baby coming. Tonight.
Oh,
stuff happening for Tyler Murray. Free throw good for Tyler Murray. Young with the rebound, lobs it up for KO.
Halifax again with some more second chance points there.
Daly picks up the foul. Moncton to inbound. Moncton to inbound right now. Daquan Brooks is in. Clint Scales is pushing. Lobs it in for Kale. He gets two.
Kale getting behind the defense there for an easy layup.
Halifax taking advantage of their size too, right? Like, lots of lobs over the top of the defenders.
Well, if you're the Miracles, you need to recognize that, right? You need to recognize the situations that you're being put in, right? If Kale's on the inside, they're gonna throw it over the top, right? So you gotta be there.
We have a timeout. We'll be back with you shortly. We're back. Here we go. Clink Scales with the ball, bringing it across. Kale makes the spin move. He goes up. That layup's off. Battle underneath for the rebound. Daly with it. Clink Scales pulls up. That shot comes off. Another battle inside. Kevin Young pulls it down. Into Daly.
You're the Miracles. You can't have 3 and 4 chances to at the basket. You got to protect the defensive board and make it a one and done. I mean, one, maybe two. I mean, you got to give credit to the Rainmen as well. They're getting in there crashing with four guys, right? But you're the Miracles. You got to protect that somehow. KO leaking out here.
.642 remaining.
Big block by Daly.
Clink Scales drops it off for Young. Young gets the layup to fall. Halifax on a little run here, playing solid defense as well. Trayvon Latham attacks the hoop.
Trey called for the foul, for the travel.
Clink Scales lobs one up for Kevin Young. He misses. Daly comes down with the rebound.
Good hands.
Away by Ferguson.
That's good hands.
Coach Land just throws a little bit more muscle onto the floor. Tyler Murray's fouled on his way to the hoop, comes up limping a little.
Well,
just jog it off.
Here's the thing, Halifax right now has a big lineup other than Clink Scales up there. Right at every position, they have an oversized lineup. So, the Miracles have to, put out the lineup to kind of match that. Because they're going to try to exploit the mismatches like we were talking about earlier today, right? So. But I also like how the Miracles are still attacking. They're still just going to the basket, not settling for jumpers. Attack, attack, attack.
Free throw good for Murray. 53-38. 5:54 remaining in the second quarter. Murray knocks them both down, gets the sub.
Murray with a little bit of a limp there.
The trainer's checking on him right now. Clink Scales gets it over to Kale. Back to Clink Scales. Kale, he's going to attack the hoop. Drops it off for McMorrow.
Definitely travel.
He travels.
Definite travel. Well, you have to put the ball down before you move. I don't think you can just grab it and start moving. If you're on the run, yes. But not when you're stationary.
Moncton to inbound. Van Zandt with the ball right now. Gets it into Brooks. Brooks picked up by Ando. Gets trapped up top. Lathan to the hoop. He's blocked when he gets there. Clink Scales comes out with it. Clink Scales putting the extra moves on Brooks after the whistle.
Coach Pep Clairol's almost taking a ball to the head.
Which is fair, because he almost tackled the ref. So.
Well, if you're standing on the court, what do you expect, right?
Kevin Young, he attacks. Good defense by Smith. Ferguson called for the foul underneath.
Fouls on number 34, Seamus Ferguson, his second.
I want to say I want to welcome all the people tuning in from Halifax, but I'm pretty sure they're all here. So if you did stay back, welcome to the game, to the broadcast here, as McMorrow makes the turnaround inside. Daquan Brooks comes across, catch the screen from Ferguson. Keeps attacking. Great no-look pass for Dwayne Smith. He's blocked underneath. Kevin Young comes out running.
Well, the Miracles are getting the shots they want.
Offensive foul.
That's a good read by Daquan getting to the spot.
Well, I mean, Kevin Young was out of control when he was before he crossed half, right? You know that's coming.
Yeah.
Offensive foul, Halifax number 28, Kevin Young. His turn.
Well, back to where I was talking about, where the Miracles are getting to the shots they want. They're getting to the basket. They're getting, like, layups and things like this. But as you see, Halifax are getting a lot of hands on them, a lot of blocks, right? So you got to try to bring them bigs out somehow.
Right.
Right?
Ando picks up the foul.
I'm not sure if you're the Miracles and you start taking a few more jumpers, try to get the bigs out. But they got to do something. They're just closing right in.
Well, the thing is, if you're gonna attack with the attack to get the contact, right?
Yes. Yes.
Because the only problem with taking more jump shots is Halifax has a lineup out there that can rebound.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. The thing is, like, I say you keep attacking them, right? Like, going to the hoop, hit the line, right?
Yes, yes.
It's just right now I find Moncton's in a little bit of a moment here where they're trying to avoid the contact, right? Let those big trees hit you. I mean, which is easier said than done while I sit up here. I don't have to run into Liam McMorrow.
Yeah. Right? Well, I give credit to Ferguson right there. That was a beautiful box out on McMorrow.
Van Zandt to the hoop for two.
Because that's the biggest thing, right? It's just fundamental basketball now, right? Just box out. That's it, right? Let other guys grab rebounds. You don't worry about grabbing the rebound.
Right.
All you do is box out. That's your job.
Right.
Right. And that's what he did right there on that last play to lead to, you know, the Miracles to get out, run easy layup by Van Zandt.
Very good.
So.
All right, we got another break here with 3:52 remaining here in the second quarter. The score is 55-42. In favor of the Halifax Rainmen over the Moncton Miracles here at the Coliseum. I'm to you with my brother Joey, and we're so thankful you're tuning in with us today.
Thank you.
We're back. Joey and I just taking our time enjoying a little bit of Whoomp. There it is.
Yeah, yeah. Love that song.
Clink Scales looks to set up the offense for Halifax.
Miracles needing a stop right here.
Absolutely. Ando with the ball. Clink Scales with a good pass into the high post. Ando comes up shooting, knocks down the three to beat the buzzer.
Big shot by Ando there. Can't say it wasn't contested. Daquan had a hand up.
Van Zandt gives it to Ferguson. Ferguson takes the hook. Dwayne Smith couldn't hold on to the rebound. Clink Scales is on his way back. Oh, Kale with the great stop and go. McMorrow battles underneath for the board. Foster checks in for Clink Scales, getting Clink Scales a well-deserved break for Halifax.
Yeah.
Watson on the catch, gets it back to
to Ando. Foster with the ball now for Halifax. Back to Ando. Picked up by Daquan Brooks. Ando goes on the attack, gets it to Watson, to McMorrow. He throws it down.
That's a big dunk by McMorrow there. Like when he elevates and goes up over the basket, it's kind of a...
Ooh, great crossover move by Brooks for the layup.
Wow. Wow. That was a nice move by Daquan Brooks there.
I forgot about the play-by-play. I went in the fan mode.
Ooh. The up and under.
The crossover was mean, too. McMorrow in the post. He's going to attack. Puts up the hook. Comes off.
Good Lathan defense.
Lobs it out to Ferguson with a great catch.
Well, you got to reward the big man after the great defense on McMorrow. He's running. Throw it up to him, right? He's going to get to the line here.
First free throw is up for Ferguson, comes off. Second one is missed as well. Ando bringing it back for Halifax, gets it up to Watson, over to KO. Ando directing the traffic. KO wanting the ball inside.
Well, there was nothing there. Lathan was right there behind him.
Foster misses.
Good team defense by the Miracles.
Brooks is trapped.
We have a definite foul there. But they're going to give that to Daquan. Well, I mean, I guess the ref couldn't see. He was on the other side. So from my vantage point, I could see a little bit more.
Van Zandt takes one to the head.
And that's good defense by Clink Scales getting the hand on it.
Clink Scales brings it across for Halifax. Over to Clink Scales. He looks into the post. Spikes goes up strong, comes off. Trayvon Lathan comes down with it. Van Zandt's pushing it. It's over to Brooks. He attacks, slows down. It's a shot up, but he gets blocked, and back comes Clink Scales. No look pass.
Big block by Trey, and ooh. I mean, that was a better block than the one Spikes had, right?
I was
going
to say, that
right? takes
I mean, me back to the first
going
quarter.
Back to Spikes and the block that he had. Wow.
Van Zandt's going back to the free throw line.
Miracle still attacking. Still liking what they're doing right now. It's like a boxing match right now. It's kind of like, you know, just working the body, right? Work the body, work the body, right? Work the body. And then, you know, eventually, you know, go for the kill. And that's with both teams right now. Yeah. Both teams just working it. Inside, 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 attack, attack, attack. So
39.4 seconds here. Remaining here in the second quarter. Clink Scales on the push. It's it over to Foster. Floater is off. Battle underneath for the board.
Klingscales gets it to Watson on a great pass.
That's a nice pass by Klingscales inside.
We're back out of the timeout, 64-46, with 15.9 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
Miracle's here looking for one good shot. Try to cut this down a bit.
Halifax picks up the foul on that one.
Yeah.
That's going to be on Apaya. Brooks makes the first. Got another timeout, 64-48, 7.4 remaining here in the second quarter. Be back with you shortly. Here we go, 7.4 seconds remaining in the second quarter. 64-48.
Miracle's right now looking for a stop. Going into this.
Austin gets it over to Watson, and time runs out.
Yeah. At the end of the half, the score is 64-48 in favor of the Halifax Rainmen over the Moncton Miracles. We're here at the Coliseum. My name's Tia with my brother Joey. We'll see you back here
see you
at the
later.
Start of the second half.
Bye.
Welcome back to the Moncton Coliseum. We're getting set here for the third quarter. I'm Tia with my brother Joey.
How you doing?
Moncton with the ball to start.
It's going to be a big quarter for the Miracles right here.
Trayvon Lathan puts it up, gets his own rebound, comes up short again. Here comes Joey Haywood. He's off and running. Loses control. Ball goes out of bounds. So do both teams.
Van Zandt with the big check. If there was boards there, oh yeah.
Oh yeah, if there were boards, somebody's putting their shoulder back in place right now.
Yeah.
Haywood with the big shot, comes up short. Battle underneath, Lathan gets the rebound. Tyler Murray's gonna bring it back. Big spin move, attacks the hoop, layup comes off.
Nice move.
Murray gets it over to Robinson. He puts it on the floor and attacks. Goes up strong, looking for the foul, doesn't get it.
Miracles are definitely getting the stops they need, and the Rainmen are getting out and running, but the Miracles are getting back in transition. So it's nice right now. Somebody needs to score, though.
Absolutely.
Trey telling Daquan Brooks there just, you know, not to worry. Let me get into position before, you know, you try to get it to me.
Ball comes into Brooks. Brooks loses the handle. Kevin Young's running. Gets it over to Haywood on the pass.
I would say that's a good foul by Trey. Yep. Put Young on the line here. Or I'm sure it's on the ground, so it's a real good foul there.
Ball comes into McMorrow, back to Haywood. Gets it over to Young. Young takes the jump shot. And it's good for Kevin Young.
Daquan Brooks running out of real estate under there.
I haven't heard that in so long. That's awesome. I love the real estate one. That one, that's one of my favorites. I haven't heard that one in a long time.
Bringing it back. McMorrow with the forearm shiver. Stanley losing it. We already know Halifax is going to play physical, so you have to play through it. I mean, in a situation like that, Stanley, yeah, you want that foul, but you got to get back because McMorrow is going to run.
Ando steps back and knocks down the jump shot.
And if you're Halifax right now, you're doing the right thing. All you're doing, you're taking the shots that they're giving you, right? The Miracles are they're getting good looks, right? Miracles getting to the basket right there. Nice play by Daquan getting there.
Haywood attacks the hoop. Layup comes off. Trayvon boxes out Stanley Robinson. Brooks to the hoop. Gets it out to Murray. Murray comes up shooting. That three's off. Kevin Young comes down with it, and he's looking to run. He gets fouled on his way to the hoop.
Young been quiet tonight. So let's see if he can come out here in this third quarter. see if he come and asserts himself, I would say. Young hitting that first one. And if you're the Miracles right now, you're not going to get everything in one shot. There's no 20-point baskets, right? So, you know, you just chip away. You get it to something manageable going into the fourth, right?
Absolutely.
Right.
Van Zandt with the ball. He's going to attack. Sit out to Murray. Two on the shot clock. Brooks has to get one up. Van Zandt's gonna run.
Once again, the Miracle's back in transition. We have a turnover.
Joey Haywood, he's just ridiculously quick.
Yeah.
Moncton takes a timeout.
That's a good timeout there by the Miracles.
Very
right
necessary.
Now. Yeah.
We'll be back with you shortly.
Here we go, we're back here in the third quarter. Current score 72-50 in favor of the Halifax Rainmen over the Moncton Miracle. Tyler Murray to inbound, here comes Daquan Brooks for the Miracles. Van Zandt with the ball, gets it over to Trayvon Lathan. He turns around, kicks it out to Brooks, he comes up shooting. Brooks knocks down the three. Big deficit right now, but easy to remember. Moncton came back from down 30 last game. So they definitely can make the comeback. Here comes Brooks, gets it out to Stanley Robinson, throws one down. Haywood gets two.
Haywood has turned it up here in this third quarter as well.
Well, he's taking advantage of his skill, right?
Yeah. Like,
Murray gets it out of the corner, kicks it over to Trayvon Lathan. He comes up shooting. That shot comes up short. McMorrow with the rebound, gets it to Young. Young's running. Count the hoop for Kevin Young.
Well, Young in the open court's a problem, right? He gets you in that open court one-on-one. It's hard. right? Miracles have been doing a good job getting back in transition, but, you know, one-on-one is a problem. McMorrow with the offensive rebound. Stepping out of bounds.
McMorrow takes his time giving the ball to the refs.
Yeah.
Trayvon Latham bringing it back for Moncton. 78-55 with 7 minutes remaining here in the third quarter.
Every possession right now is critical going into this fourth quarter.
KO with the rebound. Sit over to Saya Ando. Haywood misses the floater and then an interesting chain of events. Gets the ball back to Halifax.
Playing hot potato with it.
I don't want it, you take it. Inbounds to McMorrow. He backs down.
Ooh.
Ferguson called for the foul on the strip.
Well, if you're McMorrow, you got to, you know, give him some credit. He's going to make the refs make a decision, right? Either a foul or a strip. It looked like a clean strip to me by Seamus Ferguson, but make the refs make the decision, right?
Right.
So.
.633 remaining here in the third. Team fouls 5-0 right now in this quarter. Brooks gets it out to Van Zandt. Van Zandt with the swing, tapped away by Haywood.
Miracle trying to swing it around there.
Brooks with the step back. Can't get it to fall. Kevin Young comes down with it.
Brooks can get that shot pretty much anytime he wants, yep. Right? That step back. Especially the way that Halifax is playing off him. I like to see him drive more into the key and try that step back, right? Because it'll be wide open every time.
McMorrow gets two more. I keep looking away from the game and watching Clink Scales on the bench even. He's so entertaining. I can't quite explain it, but I think he just ate someone's food. Now he's shadow boxing with Watson and heading into the game. Oh, he's a lot of fun.
Oh, yeah. Well, you love it when a guy brings that type of intensity to the game, right? You love it. Like, it, in any situation, any game, right? When you bring that intensity, people like to be around that, right?
Dwayne Smith up strong, comes up short, but Ferguson pulls it down.
McMorrow might have got away with that, but you can't shake the whole rim. Shake everything.
KO with the deep three. Comes off. Here comes Tyler Murray.
Coming up short there.
Clinksdale gets it over to Haywood. Haywood takes the three. It's off. Mm. Gonna be Halifax ball. gets it to Watson.
Just when you think the Rain Man has fell in love with the three-pointer, they get inside. Haywood taking a tough screen there.
Out of bounds, going to be Halifax ball. McMorrow gets the putback. Van Zandt with the crossover, kicks it out to Murray. Murray takes the three. That's off. Moncton having a real hard time putting the ball in the hoop right now.
One thing I must say as a positive, they're getting to that offensive glass. Give them that. Nothing's dropping right now, that's for sure.
Van Zandt to the line for Moncton. First free throw off. Makes the second of two. Young kicks it over to Foster. Klingscales with the ball right now, back to Foster, picked up by Murray. He takes the three, and it's good. Van Zandt blocked on the attack of the hoop.
Well, the miracles of they've gotten to the basket a lot of times getting there, but I see where the Halifax has adjusted more or less. They blocked a lot of shots. I mean, their shot blocking in the last two quarters, three quarters, have been phenomenal after they were getting to the basket, getting layups, right? So basically just read and react or reacting to what's going on. They know they're going to get to the basket. So miracles need to figure out a way to kind of get back to scoring.
Dwayne Smith tries to kick it out. It's tipped away. Out of bounds, going to be Moncton ball. Ball comes into Van Zandt. Pulls up with the jump shot, knocks it down.
That's it.
Time for second half, Van Zandt to kick in.
Yeah. Well, you got to take what the defense gives you, right? We know the layups, they're done. You know what I mean? Or maybe keep attacking, but more or less, right around the key there, start hitting some jumpers. Make guys step out.
That right there is going to be a problem. If McMorrow can start hitting that jump shot as well,
yeah,
then Moncton's going to be in some real trouble. I mean, we've seen them come back from 30 already in this series, but if McMorrow's hitting that jump shot, it's going to be an issue.
And the Miracles are known of making big comebacks, right? Really big, you know, being down a lot of points and fighting their way back. I mean, they've been down in the fourth quarter by, you know, a few times by 20 and fight their way all the way back. So
And I mean, like I said, game one, they were down 30.
Yeah,
Dwayne Smith for the three comes off. Foster gets it. He's pushing. Keeps it himself. Attacks the hoop. Great move. Gets two.
It's a good move by Foster inside there.
Mm-hmm.
Van Zant knocks down the three.
It's a big shot by Van Zant.
Clint Scales gets it back to Foster. Great ball movement. Watson with it right now for Halifax. Back to Foster. Foster pulls up. That one's off. Tyler Murray goes for the rebound. It's going to be Miracle's ball on the foul. .143 remaining here in the third quarter. Sean Van Zant with the ball right now. Van Zant gets the floater up and in.
Ever since you said Van Zant time, Van Zant been hitting some big
second
shots.
Second half Van Zant's a problem, man.
Yeah.
Although 92 points on the board in the third quarter is also a problem. Sutherland kicks it out to Smith. He takes the one dribble pull-up.
And that's what you want to do, right? You're the Miracles. You want to give it the defense taking. They're collapsing. As soon as one player gets attacking inside, you know, you're leaving guys wide open at three-point line for that one up fake and an easy jumper. Right?
Watson lobs it into McMorrow. He gathers himself and goes up. Comes off. Going to be Miracle ball.
I'm loving the way the Miracles are kind of closing out this quarter, even though you're down by, you know, 25 points, right? You're closing out on a positive note, right? And hopefully we can get some momentum going into that fourth.
Van Zant pulls up. That one's off. Dwayne Smith goes down hard. Halifax comes back with it. Foster bringing it up for the Rainmen right now. 17 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. 2 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Watson puts up the floater, gets it to fall. At the end of the third, the score is 94-67 in favor of the Halifax Rainmen. We'll be back here very shortly. Here we are at the fourth quarter, 94-67 in favor of the Halifax Rainmen. Game three of this series, currently tied 1-1. Daly with the ball, gets it over to Watson. Back to Daly. He throws it down.
Good backdoor cut by Daly.
That used to be a familiar sight here in the Coliseum.
Yeah.
Couple players I miss. He's one of them.
Yeah.
That have played here. Foster steps back. That's a big deal.
That's a big shot. Yeah.
that was interesting.
Yeah. Well, see, here's the thing. If you're the Miracles, in a way, you kind of want them to fall in love with the three if you're the Rainmen, hoping they miss them so you have a chance.
But
if they're hitting shots, what do you do?
But it wasn't even so much the three for me. It was the fact that if Daquan Brooks had a foul down, that would have been Rubio. Like, he saved that highlight just by at least staying on his feet.
Patty Mills.
It was interesting. Foster on the run for Halifax. Keeps it himself, misses the layup, but McMorrow's there. He throws one down.
Brooks Apaya there with a war cry. I like that one.
Chris Matthews gets the floater to go. Foster kicks it over to Apia. Back to Foster. Watson with the ball now. Jermaine Daly takes the jump shot. It falls. There's some guys that need to get to the free throw line to see something go in to turn them on. Jermaine Daly, if he dunks, you might as well expect that he's going to do everything else after that.
Yeah.
Watson picks up the foul. Tremaire Sutherland will go to the line. .103-71, 9:55 remaining here in the fourth. Foster with the ball. Gets it out to Apia. He makes the move, kicks it inside to Spikes. He throws it down. Looks Rainmen, like All-Star Saturday night here.
Yeah,
at the
well, it's a lot of two-man game, right? The big man's rolling off, and you got to watch that, right? Rainmen getting hands on kind of every pass coming through the lane, reading everything. So Miracles need to shore it up there, make some good passes, get some good looks. I mean, you got to give credit to the Rainmen as well. I mean, the Rainmen defensively, you know, they're doing all the right things right now.
Sutherland gets it out to Brooks. Brooks with the fake, takes the three. That shot's off. Moncton with a new shot clock. Chris Matthews gets it into Dwayne Smith. Scrappy defense in there. Spikes comes down with the rebound, gets it to Apia. Great outlet to Watson. Watson gets the reset. Apia. Brooks, he's hit on the way up. Way up the floor, sorry. Wasn't a shot.
Yeah.
Saya Ando comes in for the Rainmen, giving Foster a break. Foster just played some really good minutes for Halifax.
Yes. And that's the thing, though, when you have Foster coming out and you got Ando jumping in, which really there's no real drop-off there. I mean, he's just coming in. He's just kind of filling that spot defensively.
I find for Halifax, they have at least two players at every position that could start for someone else.
Yeah.
Every position. Right? Like, I'm sitting here from our position, from our vantage point. You got a guy like Fisher who hasn't even played tonight.
Yes.
And he's good for 15 when he goes.
Yeah.
Right? Like,
for sure.
Ando with the steal, gets it up to Watson. Chris Matthews, he takes the shot. That three's off. Battle inside for the rebound. Watson throws it up. Tipped to Dwayne Smith. Gets it to Sutherland. Daly picks up the foul. Brooks with the ball. He's going to take the three. Knocks it down. Sutherland picks up the foul. Watson going to go to the line here for Halifax. 107-74 with 7:41 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Brooks with the crossover move. He gets it across half. Over to Smith. Smith puts it on the floor and attacks. Goes up strong, but he's blocked. Watson's on the run, gets it to Appiah.
Definitely was fouled there.
Underneath for two.
Definitely was fouled there. And once again, another big block by Spikes.
Appiah misses the shot. Throws it out. Spikes comes away with it. Tempers flaring a little in there.
Yeah.
Definitely a rivalry game.
But see, here's the thing. When you know, the Rainmen, they're up by so much right now, where they're still playing with that intensity.
Yeah.
You understand? Like, they're playing like it's 30 seconds left and they're down by five. You know what I mean? So the Miracles are still fighting.
That was pretty specific.
Yeah, but you know what I'm saying,
hey,
though?
Intense. Like, that was
intense.
You've been planning to say that for a couple of games, haven't you?
I saved that one.
That was that one.
But that's how you got to play, though, right? Right? When you look at it, right? If you play every position like you're down by five or three, you know, and that's how the Raymond have played, right? So. And the Miracles, I mean, a valiant effort. They come out, they fought themselves, but the Rainmen right now have the upper hand. They're still whacking, still scrapping, still and getting in their hand on everything.
We got a technical foul on Coach Pops. Coach Claros picks up the foul, the technical. Brooks to the line, misses the first free throw. Gonna be Miracle ball. Trayvon Lathan checks in for the Miracles. Want to take this opportunity to send out a shout out to Gloria Lathan, Moms.
Yeah.
He checked in with us before the game started, man. Say hi to my mother for me. So it's done. You can let him know, Mrs. Lathan, that we did our part, so he should give us an interview.
Yeah.
Next chance he gets. Halifax to inbound, 110-74 is the score. 6:45 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Ando with the ball. Ando comes up short on the floater. Brooks comes away with it. He's running.
Right idea by Brooks, but a little, it's coming in hot. It was coming in hot. A little too high. Rainmen fans over there. You could tell they're Scotians for sure. You could tell it.
That's my people. That's I ain't it, even mad at them.
That's it, right, yo?
Yo.
You could tell.
It's funny, yeah. Too, because we were talking earlier, like, Joey and I are both from Halifax.
Yeah. Transplanted
Scotians. And the fans here just showing what they're like, man. Yeah. I love it.
Yeah.
And this kind of battling in on road games and all that stuff is the kind of stuff that saves the league.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
For sure. For sure.
Sutherland goes up for two. Although that, this is our host chant.
Yeah.
Don't do that. Now that I'm thinking about it, because now I live here.
Yeah.
Don't do that.
Yeah. Well, see, you can do that in Canada. Yeah. Do that down.
Take that to the palace. Yeah.
Take that to Detroit or somewhere and say that. Okay.
Actually, hold on. Yeah. Toronto did.
Yeah.
Never mind. That's not
Detroit. Yeah. True. True.
Lathan with the ball. Dwayne Smith. Fallahan, he goes up looking to dunk on someone. Five 10 remaining here in the fourth.
Or more or less, take it to one of the original six. If it was hockey, you're looking at hockey, original six teams. Go to Montreal.
Yeah.
And you a Boston fan, start saying that.
Yeah.
Or vice versa.
Foster, he misses, but Daly's on the boards. Blocked by Fallahan. Daly tracks it down. Got a shot clock problem. Shouldn't have been reset on that block.
That was a big shot block by Fallahan, protecting the rim.
.447 remaining here in the fourth quarter. Adjust the shot clock to 11 seconds on it. 4:47 in the fourth quarter. As I said, 110-79 in favor of the Halifax Rainmen over the Moncton Miracles. We're back, 110-79. Foster with the ball. Shot comes off. Ando gets away with the rebound. Halifax admittedly is just playing tougher right now.
Well, if you're the Miracles, you're going to work on a few things now. So make some adjustments, see what's going on. Protect, like the rebound wise, see if a few things work, because right now the game's a little bit out of hand scoring wise. Get a couple easy baskets for some guys, get some confidence in the bench.
Follahan knocks in the free throw. 112-82, favor the Rainmen with 4:14 remaining here in the fourth. Ando gets it to Daly. Spikes puts it back. Daquan Brooks coming for Moncton.
Well, Follahan right there is going for that shot block, right? And you still got to watch your man, right? Spikes right behind you, easy layup, right? So, I mean, you want the shot block, but you can't be out of position.
Brooks is going to go to the line for Moncton.
Or if you're going to be out of position, you got to make sure that your man is picked up by somebody.
Tyler Murray steps in for Moncton.
Defense.
Gets it out to Young. You know what's going to happen when he gets that.
Yeah. That's kind of the tail of the game, kind of in the way there, where Moncton was on a 4-on-0, and then the ball kind of got stolen, and the Rainmen went on the 4-on-0 the other way. Where, big shot by Daquan Brooks there.
Young gets it around the back to Spikes. I mean, this Halifax team is just simply picking Moncton apart. Like,
good sportsmanship by Spikes there, helping Daquan up.
Clink Scales holding his arm.
Yeah.
That's his sixth personal foul.
Brooks to the line.
Well, here's the big thing. You got to play four quarters, right?
Right.
You come out the first quarter, if you're the Miracles, you play nice there. I mean,
crazy lob.
Nice lob, they're young. Going back to that, you can't take quarters off against the Rainmen. You can't. defensively and offensively, on rebounds, on everything. In defensive intensity, you have to give every possession. It got to be life or death.
Yeah. Especially against a team like this. You can't make mistakes against Halifax.
Yeah.
At all.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, even when they run their second unit,
yeah,
it's a starting lineup.
Like, you have another offensive rebound there by Watson. Like, to reset. Clink scales, definitely traveling. And if you're the Rainmen, you know, you did your job, right?
Right.
You did your job. You took home court back now, right? You know what I mean? So, credit to them. Miracles need to come back in game four, regroup, figure out the things that was working for them in that game one and go back to it.
Brooks steps back. That one's way off. Young comes down with it.
That's a tough shot by Brooks there. That was a sick move by Apaya there. Off his foot and kissed the ball and laid it up.
And yep. One mixtape style.
Yeah, that was nice. I like that one. Oh!
Hand just dunked over Kevin Young.
Do not jump.
Then that kind of makes it all worth it.
No, now. Yes, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, you're right.
I mean, I'd rather win, but.
And you'd like to see more of that by Follahan, though. Like, I mean, if you're going to do that.
Bro.
Like, now I see what you got. Come on now. Anywhere around that circle. If you jump, you're done.
Final score is 124-96. Halifax Rainmen take game three. Series is now 2-1 in favor of the Rainmen. We'll see you back here Tuesday, 7 o'clock for game four.
See you
I'm
later.
Pia with my brother Joey, and we're out of here.
Peace.